Thank you. The next item of business is a statement by Minister Siobhan Brown on new safeguards in relation to XL bully dogs. The Minister will take questions at the end of her statement, and so there should be no interventions or interruptions. And I call on Siobhan Brown. Up to 10 minutes, please, Minister. Could we have Ms Brown's microphone, please? Could we have Ms Brown's microphone, please? Ah, Ms Brown.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Let me begin by explaining the reason for the Scottish Government's policy decision to introduce new safeguards in reaction to XL bully dogs. These new safeguards, which will include a requirement for XL bully dogs to be muzzled and kept on a lead in public places, will help ensure public safety. This was not a decision that has been taken lightly. It follows as a direct result of the UK Government's decision to introduce new controls on the XL bully dog for owners living in England and Wales. Such a decision was for the UK Government to make for owners in England and Wales, but the UK Government failed, however, to fully consider the knock-on impacts of that decision. As the First Minister set out last week, the UK Government failed to act to stop dog owners in England and Wales evade the new controls by bringing their dogs to Scotland. That changed the balance of whether we needed to act here in Scotland. Presiding Officer, these are exceptional circumstances in which we find ourselves. Mm-hmm. It means that it is now right and proper that we replicate the controls being implemented south of the border. This does not mean that the Scottish Government is moving away from the deed, not breed approach, recognised by dog control experts as being the most effective way of keeping communities safe. The Scottish Parliament should be proud of the legislation that has created a system of dog control notices that can be served on an owner of any dog that is out of control as a proportionate step to reduce the risk of the dog becoming dangerously out of control. Scotland is unique in this position in comparison to the rest of the UK. The Control of Dogs Scotland Act 2010 enables local authorities to serve dog control notices to deal with out-of-control dogs at an early stage. And I can confirm that the Scottish Government will be looking in the medium term to work with key stakeholders and interested parties to look at potential improvements to the 2010 Act that could enhance and strengthen the general preventative dog control notice regime in Scotland. Presiding Officer, we recognise the vast majority of dog owners are responsible animal lovers and will want to keep their XL bully dogs and comply with these safeguards when they are introduced. The importance of responsible dog ownership is hugely important, but sadly there are some cases of irresponsible dog ownership that can understandably lead to operational challenges for the police as well as local authority dog wardens. Issues could arise with dogs being neglected, not exercised, and generally just not compatible with the owner's lifestyle, leading to behavioural issues. Presiding Officer, while the focus today is on XL bully dogs, any dog has a propensity to become out of control or even dangerous if it's not trained properly, socialised properly, and not kept under proper control at all times in all places. I was struck by the courage of someone who had lived experience of having been attacked by a dog when I met with them last month. The individual spoke bravely when telling their story of how they'd suffered a bite dog attack resulting with physical, emotional and financial consequences which were severe, caused by the incident. And I'm aware that there have been a range of views on the decision made, but I want to place on record my thanks to all those that I've met in recent weeks for their helpful engagement, input, expertise and time. Presiding Officer, just as it is in the case in England and Wales, I must stress these are new safeguards rather than a ban, and it's important people understand the effect of the new safeguards. There are thousands of applications from XL bully owners in England and Wales from owners who have sought exemption certificates to enable them to keep their XL bully dogs. It would therefore be wrong to categorise the safeguards, whether in Scotland, England or Wales, as a ban. Presiding Officer, I've heard from many concerned voices in recent weeks around the impact of this policy. And we will, of course, continue to engage with stakeholders to hear about the practical issues arising, and we will carefully consider these for Scotland. From my discussions to date, I'm aware of concerns related to veterinary capacity given the uncertainty around the number of XL bully dog owners who will require vet assistance. I'm also conscious of the possible impact on animal welfare organisations and wider issues connected to the designation of dogs under the dangerous dogs legislation, both in terms of the impact of some of the safeguards and the wider implications. These issues will continue to require serious consideration, and I am happy to discuss those as we implement the safeguards in Scotland. Presiding Officer, it is important that members, XL bully dog owners, and the general public understand what the new safeguards will mean. Subject to approval by Parliament, the effect of the new Scottish controls will be to mean owners will need to make a decision about whether to keep their dogs. There will be two stages to this new safeguards regime. From a date that we will announce, the first stage will mean it will be an offence in Scotland to sell an XL bully dog, to abandon an XL bully dog or let it stray, to give away an XL bully dog, to breed from an XL bully dog, or to have an XL bully dog in public without a lead or a muzzle. The second stage will be the deadline to apply for your dog to be added to the exemption index. After this date, which again will be announced in the coming period, it will be an offence to own an XL bully dog unless you either have an exemption certificate or have applied for a certificate. This two-stage approach will give a limited amount of time for XL bully owners to make an informed decision about what they want to do with their dogs. It is appropriate to give this opportunity, however, once the new regime is in place, the owner will need to decide to keep their dog and, if so, to adhere to the new safeguards or to no longer keep their dog. And for those who wish to keep their dog and comply with the new safeguards, a fee will be payable to apply to registered dog on the exemption index. And compensation will be payable for those owners who no longer wish to keep their dogs. The amount of the fee and the compensation payable will be set out in regulations and confirmed in the coming period. But just for reference, the equivalent amounts in England and Wales are £92.40 for the register, for the dog to be on the exemption index, and either £100 or £200 for the loss of a dog subject to euthanisation and payment for the process of euthanising your dog, depending on whether this service was paid for. In addition to the need for a muzzle and keeping your dog on a lead, the new safeguards operating as part of the exemption include having your dog microchipped and neutered. The specific dates for these stages will be set out in legislation to be laid and agreed by Parliament, but we are working at pace to urgently develop necessary regulations. Dog owners in Scotland should therefore start to consider what they may wish to do with their XL bully dogs. And given what the Scottish Government has announced, I would suggest it would be sensible for any prospective owners of XL bully dogs to seriously bear in mind the need to adhere to the new safeguards if they are minded to acquire an XL bully dog where they currently do not own one. We will develop guidance and practical support to allow owners to understand the legislation of what is required. And this will include details on how to identify an XL bully dog using the standard developed by the UK Government. Presiding Officer, for Scotland, we must recognise the consequences of the UK Government's policy on XL bully dogs. Effectively, if we see owners in England and Wales able to rid of their XL bully dogs here in Scotland, we therefore have to act and enhance safeguards that will help to keep the public safe. It's therefore right to replicate the regime in England and Wales so that we remove the ability of English and Welsh dog owners to use Scotland to get rid of their dogs. Moving forward, we will be considering issues that have arisen as a consequence of the UK Government's policy. and we will also continue to work closely with stakeholders to look at mitigating, where appropriate, the impact of any unintended consequences of these controls. Finally, despite the need to introduce these new safeguards, we remain committed to the fundamental principles of the Scottish approach. The situation with XL bully dogs is unique, but we remain unequivocally committed to deed and not breed. Thank you, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Minister. The Minister will now take questions on the issues raised in her statement. I intend to allow around 20 minutes for questions, after which time we will move on to the next item of business. And those members who would wish to ask a question, please press your request to speak buttons. And I call Russell Findlay.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and I thank the Minister for advance sight of her statement. For fans of SNP grievance output, this really is a belter. Adults and children across the UK have been maimed and killed by XL bullies. In response, and quite rightly, UK ministers moved quickly to protect the public. They banned the breeding, sale, exchange or gifting of these dangerous and powerful animals. But the SNP decided to reject the same measures. We know that seeking divergence from the UK is what gets these people out of bed in the morning. But putting petty nationalist point scoring above public safety surely marks a new low. I note that 11 SNP MSPs have already stated their opposition to this ban. But will they now show some teeth, or will they retreat with their tails between their legs? My colleague Jamie Green and others have warned that the SNP's stupidity would result in an influx of XL bullies into Scotland. And that is exactly what is happening. So for the Minister to stand here today and try to blame others is pathetic. What an absolute brass neck. The people of Scotland are not daft. So can she tell them, while she and Humza Yousaf dithered, how many XL bullies have been brought into Scotland? And will she now take some responsibility for her inaction and apologise to anyone who suffers harm as a result?
Minister.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Just for clarity, Mr Findlay says that we dithered and delayed and refused to follow the ban down south in England and Wales, and that is inaccurate. I wrote to the UK government after I had my first letter in mid-November saying that we would not be following the same timescale. We have in place dog control notices which allow dangerous dogs to be on lead and muzzles, which was going to be implemented in England and Wales on the 31st of December. We had that in place. I then engaged with stakeholders over the past few weeks, and when I wrote to the Minister, I asked about the legalities of dog owners.
Minister, please resume your seat. I'm not having all the sedentary chuntering here. Mr Lumsden, please don't interrupt the Minister who was on. Sorry if it was Mr Lumsden, Mr Findlay, one of the two of you. Anyway, gentlemen, you're both looking equally sheepish, if I may say so. Minister, please resume.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I think it's just important to reiterate and to understand the reason why the Scottish Government has been left with little choice in making this decision. The Scottish Government was engaging with dog control interests in Scotland to help assess the principle of introducing the new safeguards to XL bully dogs. However, there was a base based on the position in Scotland unaffected by the introduction of the new safeguards in England and Wales on XL bully dogs. Now that the UK government has been unable to provide a definite statement on whether the new controls on selling XL bully dogs apply to dogs owners living in England and Wales who seek to sell their dogs outside England and Wales, that has changed our consideration.
Colin Smith.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and thank you to the Minister for advance sight of our statement. Presiding Officer, this has been another example of the inability of our two governments to work together, and we've seen the consequence of that lack of alignment, that confusion in recent weeks. But now the Government has proposed a ban in Scotland. The Home Minister will work with the SSPCA and others to ensure it is workable, giving the police, the vets, the local authorities the resources they need to enforce it, and support for owners on low incomes with the cost of exemptions at a time of a cost of living crisis. But will the Minister recognise that appalling dog attacks occur when irresponsible owners fail to keep their dogs of many breeds under control, yet those owners often escape with nothing more than a rap on the knuckles from the court. It's 5 years since the government promised to take action against irresponsible owners and breeders, so it's simply not good enough for the Minister to say she will work in the medium term to look at potential improvements to the utterly inadequate Control of Dogs Act. Does she not accept we need action now from the government, with stronger powers for councils and the police and the courts, that make clear responsibility ultimately lies with irresponsible owners and with irresponsible breeders?
Minister.
Thank you. Firstly, I will most definitely, as I have in past several weeks, be working with all stakeholders moving forward as we create this legislation to replicate the England and Wales moving forward. Just to go back to the report back from 2019 for Scottish Government to take action, there has been action since that report in 2019. The Scottish Government did deliver a digital social media campaign in 2021 to promote the importance of responsible dog ownership, and has since rerun the elements of the campaign on several occasions. We have also put in place in 2022 the dog control notices scheme throughout all local authorities, and there's currently over 1,200 dogs on the database, and that's a relief. The figures for that are released on a weekly basis. As I said in my opening speech, we are committed to reviewing the dog control legislation of 2010. And if we look at the Dangerous Dog Acts from 1991, the Scottish Government led a working group made up of stakeholders, including Police Scotland, the Crown Office, the Procurator, Fiscal Service, Royal Mail, the Communications Working Union, Scottish Community Safety Network and the Scottish SPCA back in 2022 to assist taking forward the Scottish Government's commitment to review the 1991 Act. The working group has undertaken this review and we are now considering the wide range of views offered to determine what may be appropriate as next steps.
I would advise the Chamber that obviously we have a number of members who are seeking to ask a question of the Minister, and so I would appreciate succinct questions and answers to match. And I call Ruth McGuire to be followed by Jamie Green. Ms McGuire.
Presiding Officer, I've been contacted by constituents, responsible owners of well-trained, well-looked-after American XL bullies who are beloved family pets. They rightly point out that bullies are a breed of dog, not a type of dog. Through the decades, various different dog breeds have been deemed dangerous when actually the problem was at the other end of the lead. Deeds, not breeds, is a sensible approach. Can the Minister outline whether the Scottish Government intends to keep the regulations under review and issue in a position to give an outline of the review process?
Minister.
Thank you. The member raises an important question, and I want to be clear, as the First Minister was earlier at FMQs, that the safeguards being introduced does not mean the Scottish Government are moving away from the deed not breed approach, which is recognised by dog control experts as being the most effective way of keeping communities safe. The dog control approach in Scotland, as set out in the Control of Dogs Scotland Act 2010, has been and remains focused on the actions of the owners of dogs to maximise responsible dog ownership. And I agree with you that it is the owners who hold the key to keeping communities safe from out of control and dangerous dogs. However, given the specific situation arising here from the actions of the UK government, the Scottish government has been left with little choice in making this decision. What we are committed to is, over the medium term, a further assessment on how the local authority enforcement powers in the 2010 Act can be improved so communities can better be protected from out-of-control dogs. And I will engage with all of those who have an interest, including the member.
Jamie Green, to be followed by Emma Harper.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Sadly, lives and limbs have been lost as a result of the most horrendous of attacks. Data that I uncovered show that there have been 9,500 hospital admissions in Scotland since the flagship 2010 Act was enabled. Taking action in Scotland should have been a proactive one, not a reluctant one, as the case may currently be. Nonetheless, let me ask the Minister, given that five specific dog breeds account for over half of the current dog control notices, how confident is she that the government's deed not breed approach is actually leading to improved public safety, because statistics seem to suggest otherwise?
Minister.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I think on the dog control notices that I get from local authorities on a weekly basis, where we have over 1,200 dogs, There is not one distinct breed. There are crossbreeds, but I do know the XL Bully does not actually come in the top 10 of those. So I do not agree with Jamie Green regarding the data. But I just want to reiterate that since this announcement, I've been engaging extensively with stakeholders, and it's important for the member to understand the reason why the Scottish Government has been left with little choice in this decision. As a member will be aware, the UK Government has been unable to provide a definite statement on whether the new controls on selling or giving XL bullies apply to those seeking to give them away in Scotland, and that has significantly changed our consideration in recent weeks.
I call Emma Harper to be followed by Richard Leonard.
Since the announcement of the changes to legislation related to XL Bulldogs in England, we have seen reports of people bringing their XL Bulldogs to Scotland, including examples of XL Bulldog puppies being abandoned on the Scottish side of the border. Can the Minister give assurances that any legislation in Scotland will have principles of animal welfare as part of the legislation, and that the Government is working with animal welfare organisations to ensure that any dogs which have been brought to Scotland are properly looked after and dealt with?
Minister.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. As my statement made clear, this is not a decision taken lightly, but the Scottish Government has been left with little choice, and I'm aware there is a range of views of the new safeguards. We are mindful of the possible impact on animal welfare organisations of this law change, and we will continue to engage with animal welfare organisations and other key stakeholders to help us understand the impact of the regulations that will be introduced to the safeguards of XL bully dogs. And the Scottish Government has stated on many occasions that animal welfare is a matter that we take very seriously, and I'm happy to assure the member that we will continue to work closely with local authorities and animal welfare stakeholders as this has progressed. And I can confirm I'm urgently planning to discuss these issues raised by stakeholders in my recent discussions with Gillian Martin, who's the Minister for Energy and Environment, who has animal welfare under her remit.
I call Richard Leonard to be followed by Jim Fairley.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. Dog attacks are a serious issue. I have a constituent, Evelyn Baginski, who petitioned this Parliament demanding action on dog-on-dog attacks. I've got an old friend, Dave Sneller, who I had to drive to Crosshouse Hospital when part of his finger was bitten off as we delivered election leaflets. Far from being an excuse for postponement, the lockdown meant a huge increase in dog ownership, and so is the occasion for change. So when will the Scottish Government stop being piecemeal, stop dragging its feet, turbocharge its working group reviewing the 2010 Act, undertake an urgent review and come back to this Parliament with clear and comprehensive reforms instead of being reactive, haphazard and sluggish?
Minister.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I think your assumptions that we are reactive, I have to be honest, we have to be reactive in this particular situation, because we only found about, it was announced on the 31st of October that the first stage was going to be implemented in England and Wales. So this is why we didn't follow the 8-week timescale that England and Wales did, and we've taken our time to speak to stakeholders. We're not dragging our heels. As I've already said, we have reviewed the Dangerous Dog Act 1991, and we will be determining what may be the next appropriate steps. And as I said in my speech, we will be looking at potential improvements to the Dog Control 2010 Act that could enhance and strengthen the general preventative dog control notices in Scotland.
I call Jim Fairley to be followed by Alex Cochrane.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Minister, the UK Government, by not consulting the Scottish Government and making a knee-jerk election year desperate promise, they have demonised the very good responsible owners by playing constitutional politics. The DCN notice system is working well for all breeds in Perthshire, so can the Minister say how many DCNs have been imposed in Perth? And also, if the UK Government legislation states that a bully dog cannot be given away, how can they claim, or did they claim, that giving a dog to a Scottish rescue centre or a new home in Scotland was not an offence, but doing the same in England and Wales was an offence?
Minister.
Member raises a very important point. It is a lack of certainty from the UK Government as to the effect of their own legislation that has led to this decision. The UK Government are not certain English and Welsh dog owners would be committing an offence in selling their XL bully dogs outside England and Wales. I think the definition in the letter was unlikely, which was left the Scottish Government with little choice to act to ensure no undue risk to public safety in Scotland. Just in relation to dog control notices, and I recently met with Perth and Kinross Council dog wardens team, and I agree they're doing a great job there using their powers. And I think they've currently got 65 live dog control notices in place. And we know not all local authorities make such good use, and I would encourage all local authorities to seek to use their preventative powers in helping keep their communities safe whatever the breed of dog. We will give more consideration to what we can do alongside local authorities to encourage more consistent deployment of the powers that they've got to help with dangerous dog. And for clarity, the Scottish Government saying that they refuse to ban XL bully dogs in Scotland, which was in the press, was inaccurate. I wrote to the UK Government in November saying that we would not be following the same timescale as England and Wales.
I call Alex Cole-Hamilton to be followed by Fulton McGregor.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Presiding Officer, given the loss of life and serious injury involved in other parts of the UK pertaining to this dog breed, it's right that we bring forward measures to address the issue, such as the safeguards announced by the Minister today. But this case has underscored a pressing need to review our legislation covering dangerous dogs in its entirety and how dog control regimes interact across our four nations. While these provisions may provide necessary safeguards for dogs homed in domestic settings, I want to interrogate part of the exchange that the Minister had with Emma Harper, as I seek some clarity from the Minister around those XL bullies who are currently being looked after by organisations like Dogs Trust and RSPCA. So can I ask the Minister if the exemption certificate could extend to those dogs who are currently kennelled with animal welfare charities whose organisational values prohibit them from destroying a healthy animal, or will the law require these dogs to be euthanised as they are in England?
Minister.
Thank you. Just regarding legislation, as I already have mentioned in my speech, the Scottish Government will be looking to work with key stakeholders and interested parties to look at potential improvements to the Dog Control 2010 Act that could enhance and strengthen the general preventative dog control notices in Scotland. On the point of the puppies being taken in at the borders into rehoming, we will be looking at the legislation moving forward, but at this time we are looking to replicate what England and Wales are doing. It is my understanding that if anybody does have an XL bully dog in Scotland at this present time, they will have to follow the safeguarding procedures that we will legislate for.
I would advise the Chamber, I have four more members seeking to ask a question. I would hope to take all four, but I will need succinct questions and answers. Fulton McGregor to be followed by Liam Kerr.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I am disappointed that we're having to replicate the UK Government legislation here. Legislation that has been widely criticised by animal welfare organisations and experts such as the SSPCA and Blue Cross as being rushed through and with potential to make the situation more dangerous, not safer. That said, this is not a criticism of the Scottish Government or indeed the Minister, who I know has worked her socks off to find solutions. We've been effectively backed into a corner here with the unfortunate influx of XL bullies from England, a result of this poorly drafted UK legislation. Therefore, my question to the Minister is this: what discussions and considerations were given to trying to find solutions, legislative or otherwise, to the issue of bullies being brought to Scotland before the decision was made to replicate the UK legislation?
Minister.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. As I said in my statement, the Scottish Government decision is not one decision that we have taken lightly here, and it reflects that specific circumstances that has arisen in order to reduce the undue impact on Scotland, on the new safeguards that have been operating in England and Wales. We will need to replicate them. The Control of Dogs Scotland Act 2010 is, of course, not focused on any one breed. It is a deed, not breed approach. So any specific measures targeting XL bully dogs take a different approach, which would, of course, run contrary to overriding principles of the 2010 Act. We need to acknowledge that other situations might arise like this in the future, and we will want to ensure that we have legislation here in Scotland that enables us to keep people safe and enables the effective control of dogs in certain circumstances.
Liam Kerr to be followed by Maggie Chapman.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. So after months of Scottish Conservative pressure, the SNP has decided to ban XL bully dogs in Scotland, despite the First Minister earlier this month saying there was no need, a position which rather contrasts with the confused attempts to suggest it's a timescale issue. But how much taxpayer money has had to be spent and will be spent going forward on things like developing bespoke legislation, consulting with stakeholders, none of which would have been needed if the UK legislation had been adopted in the first place.
Minister.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I think it's very, very important that we engage with Scottish stakeholders. Just don't override and put legislation through that comes up from down south, and that's what I have been doing in recent weeks. As the member is aware, the UK government has been unable throughout, and let's not make it months and months, this has been a very short process, to give a definite statement on whether the new controls of selling or giving away XL bullies applies in Scotland. And that is why it has changed our consideration.
And I call Maggie Chapman to be followed by Christine Green.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. The Scottish Greens do not believe that banning ill-defined dog breeds is the best way to ensure either community safety or high animal welfare standards. So I welcome the Minister's assurance that these measures are not a ban. Will she say how the approach in Scotland will allow us to tackle the problems with rogue breeders and irresponsible owners? And will she agree to a summit with animal welfare organisations, vets and others to develop a coherent strategic approach on this issue?
Minister.
Thank you. I thank Maggie Chapman for that question. Animal welfare is not only an important issue, but an emotive one. The Scottish Government takes animal welfare very seriously and is committed to the highest possible welfare standards. And we need to emphasise to people that they must be responsible owners and act responsibly when deciding to buy a dog or take one into their lives. I've already met with a number of animal welfare organisations, as well as representatives from the British Veterinary Association, to discuss the issue of XL bully dogs, and I'm happy to assure the member that this engagement and that of other relevant members will continue. The Scottish Government has already been engaging with key animal welfare stakeholders, including the veterinary profession, on the issue of low welfare dog breeding for some considerable time, and we will continue to work with stakeholders to address the issues through the Pet Trade Task Force, led by the Scottish SPCA. And on the issue of a summit, I am happy to speak to my colleague, Minister Gillian Martin, on that subject.
And I call Christine Graham.
Thank you very much, Deputy Presiding Officer. I remain convinced, as I have from the start, that the proposed regulations are ill-considered and unjust to decent owners, and demonising a breed is not the answer. As the author of the Control of Dogs Scotland Act 2010, a member's bill, it introduced the concept of deed, not breed. And I say to Russell Finlay, if he could just switch off the sensationalism for a moment, only 2% of issued dog control notices apply to XL bully type breeds. So I'm pleased to hear voices around the chamber looking for a review and amendments to the Control of Dogs Scotland Act. I hope it's done urgently. I hope the Act is given the publicity it deserves. The public are not aware of it. Some professionals are not aware of it. And my final request is that we have a national dog microchipping database, because they're all in different databases at the moment, so we can track the dogs and irresponsible owners.
Minister.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and I would like to thank the member for the question, but also thank Christine Graham for her member's bill, which brought in the Dogs Control Scotland Act back in 2010, and I have met the member in recent days, and I'm more than happy to consider any suggestions of strengthening legislation in the future with the member.
Thank you, Minister. That concludes the statement, and there will be a very short pause before we move on to the next item of business. Thank you.